मैथमेटिक्स क्लास 12 चैप्टर 6 एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डेरिवेटिव्स मिसेलेनियस एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चन नंबर 10। द सम ऑफ पेरीमीटर ऑफ सर्कल एंड स्क्वायर इज के कांस्टेंट। प्रूव दैट सम ऑफ द एरिया इज लीस्ट व्हेन साइड ऑफ स्क्वायर इज डबल द रेडियस ऑफ अ सर्कल। लेट एक्स बी द साइड ऑफ अ स्क्वायर, सो कंसिडर अ स्क्वायर इट्स साइड इज एक्स, एंड आर बी द रेडियस ऑफ अ सर्कल, कंसिडर अ सर्कल हुज रेडियस इज आर। Given that sum of their perimeter is constant, it's given in the question. So perimeter of a circle is 2 pi r and perimeter of a square is 4x equal to constant k. Transfer 4x here becomes minus divide by 2 pi. So r is equal to k minus 4x divided by 2 pi. What they have asked, side of a square is double the radius of a circle. So I have to prove side of the square, that is I'm considering x. So x is equal to 2r. This is what you have to prove it. Now sum of the area, sum of the area, that is area of the circle and the square. Area of the circle is pi r square and area of the square is x square. R value put from here, so pi k minus 4x by 2 pi whole square plus this x square. Now 2 pi cube square is 4 pi square, so I put here. And this you expand using a plus b whole square, a minus b. So k square minus 4 into 2, 8kx plus 4x whole square, that is 16x square plus this x square. Then 1 pi you cut. Now I'll differentiate with respect to x. So dA by dx is equal to 1 by 4 pi, k square is 0 minus x is 1, so minus 8k plus x square is 2x, that is 16 into 32x plus x square is 2x. Now for the least value, area has to be, differential of area has to be 0. So I equate with 0. Before they take LCM, so 4 into 2, that is 8, and this pi also and x also, so 4 pi, transfer here, multiply with 0, cancel 0, all are multiple of x, 8, so divide by 8, so when you divide here 8, here remains minus k, plus here remains 32 by 8, that is 4x, here divide by 8, so x pi equal to 0, put the value of k is here, 2 pi r plus 4x, so put the value of k here, so minus bracket 2 pi r plus 4x plus 4x plus x pi. Open the bracket. So here minus 2 pi x plus will become minus 4x. This 4x x pi plus 4x and minus 4x cut. You and then from these two remaining you take my pi common. So here minus 2 r, here plus x equal to 0. Pi you transfer here, 0 by pi is 0. Minus 2 is equal to plus x, transfer here minus x. Cancel the minus both the sides. So x equal to 2 r. So this is the side and this is the radius. Radius is double the side of the square. That is what you have to prove. X is equal to 2r. Question number 11. A window is in the form of rectangle and surmounted by a semicircular opening. The total perimeter is 10 meter. Find the dimension of the window to admit maximum light through hole opening. You are given a window in this shape. A rectangle is there and a semicircle is on top. Let x and y be the length and breadth of the rectangular part of a window. I take x here, this y, okay, and see this, the semicircle is here, so this will be the center. So if I take this total length as x, this will be the center of this semicircle, then the radius will become x by 2. Okay, so from here to here will come x by 2. So this is the radius will be x by 2. Therefore, the radius of a semicircular surmount is x by 2. Given that total perimeter is 10, it's given in your equation that perimeter is 10. Perimeter total means semicircle plus rectangle equal to 10. Semicircle perimeter is the 2 pi r. Okay, so 2 pi r, but it is half. Okay, this is half only. So it will be pi r, and pi r means pi. What is r? R is x by 2. So x by 2, so it is pi x by 2, okay, and rectangle, it will be x plus y, okay, for rectangle this much part only, because this is already counted in the radius, circle, so x plus y means x plus 2y, so I have written x plus 2y is equal to 10, and then take LCM here, so 2x, 2 into 2, 4y divided by 2 equal to 10. 2 you transfer, multiply with 10, so you get 20. Okay, then transfer all pi x and 2x this side, it becomes minus. So 20 minus pi x minus 2x. Then here 4y is there, so 4 also you transfer, it will go in the denominator. So I can divide 20 by 4, that is 5. Here I am just taking xx common, minus x common. So here remains pi plus 2 divided by 4. Call it equation number 1. Area of a window is equal to area of a rectangle plus area of semicircle. They have said the maximum air to admit. Okay, so for that you have to have area maximum, then only maximum light to enter. Okay, so you should have, the area should be maximum. So area of the window is equal to area of the rectangle plus area of the semicircle. So area of the rectangle is length to breadth, that is x into y. And area of the semicircle is, or any circle is, pi r square. But it is semicircle, so you get half. So half pi r square. So pi half, so this is 2, 1 by 2 pi r square. R is what? X. So x by 2 whole square. So pi by 2 x by 2 whole square equal to y value put from number 1. Okay, this value 5 minus x pi plus 2 by 4 I put here. Okay, so here instead of y you put here plus pi by 2, that is pi. Okay, 2 square is 4, 4 into 2 8, so 8, and this is x square. Okay, I am also multiplying inside, so 5x here minus x into x square pi plus 2 divided by 4 plus this one as it is pi by 8 x square. Now all is in x term, differentiate with respect to x. So when you differentiate here, da by dx equal to 5, x is 1, minus x square is 2x pi plus 2 by 4 constant as it is plus 8 pi by 8 x square is 2x. For maximum light to enter, da by dx has to be 0. So this value has to be 0. So 5 minus 2x pi by plus 4 plus 2 by 4 plus 2 pi x by 8 equal to 0. Here you can cut. Okay, so when you cut, here remains 4. I take LCM. LCM is 4, so I am not cutting this. So 4 is the LCM, so here multiply by 4. So 20 minus 2x plus 2 plus here cut, so here remains 2 cancel. So here remains pi x equal to 0. And that denominator I am transferring here and multiplying with 0, so it becomes 0. Then this 20x you transfer here becomes minus 20. Okay, but I am already changing the sign. This minus I am making plus, this plus I am making minus. So this is the, this which is transferring will be minus will become plus. Okay, now I am opening the bracket. Before opening the bracket, I am taking x common first. Okay, so from here x common and 2 multiply here. So 2 pi plus 2 into 2 4 minus here remains pi equal to 20. 2 pi minus 20, that means plus pi and 4. This x is here. Now 4 plus pi transfer here, go in the denominator, so get 20 by 4 plus pi. This is the value of x, that is the length. Now you have to find the width. So for width, put in equation 1 the value of y. Okay, y value is this much. So instead of x, we place that. So y is equal to 5 minus x pi plus 4 pi plus 2 by 4. Put x value is this, 20 by 4 plus pi. 4 and 20 cut. So here pi plus 2, 5 pi plus 2 divided by 4 plus pi. Pi 5 multiply here. So 5 pi plus 10 divided by pi plus 4. Then I am taking LCM. So 5 pi, 5 into 4, 20 minus 5 pi. When you are multiplying and taking LCM is here, plus will become minus 10. 20 minus 10 is 10, 5 pi minus 5 pi cut, pi plus 4. So this is y. So you have found, they have asked us find the dimension of the window to get admit the maximum light. So dimension means length and breadth you have to find. So x is equal to this one from here, 20 divided by 5 pi plus 4 meter, and breadth will be this one, 10 by pi plus 4 meter. And radius if you want you can find, but we are asked to find length and breadth. Question number 14. Find absolute maximum and minimum value of fs is equal to cos square x plus sin x. X belongs to 0 to pi. Differentiate, so cos power 2 is 2 cos x and cos is sin. Minus sin. Plus sin is cos. Minus you take, so 2 sin x cos x plus cos x. For maximum or minimum value, f dash has to be 0. So equate with 0, I'll take cos common. Here remains minus 2 sin x plus here remains 1 equal to 0. Equate, either this is 0 or this is 0. So cos x equal to 0 and this one minus 2 sin x plus 1 equal to 0. If this is 0, then I know cos 90 is 0. So I can write instead of 0 cos pi by 2. So that means x equal to pi by 2. So one value of x is pi by 2. Here plus 1 you transfer here becomes minus 1. Minus 2 transfer, minus minus cancel, you get 1 by 2. So sin x equal to sin pi by 4. We know that sin pi by 4 or sin 30 is 1 by 2. So put sin pi by 4. That means x is equal to pi by 4. We have got the value pi by 2, pi by 6, and the interval is 0 to pi. So put all these 4 values in your function here. And the maximum value will be absolute maximum, minimum value will be minimum value, absolute minimum. Putting x equal to pi by 2, pi by 6, pi, 0 in the equation of function, that is fx equal to cos square x plus sin x. So f pi by 2 cos square pi by 2 plus sin pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is 0, sin pi by 2 is 1, so 0 plus 1 is 1. Then pi by 6, cos square pi by 6 plus sin pi by 6. Cos pi by 6 is root 3 by 2 square, and this is 1 by 2. 3 by 4, take LCM, 3 plus 2 by 4, 5 by 4, which is 1.25. F of pi, so cos square pi plus sin square pi. Cos pi is minus 1, but minus 1 square is plus 1, and sin pi is 0, so 1 plus 0 is 1. Then 0, so cos square 0, sin 0. Cos 0 is 1, sin 0 is 0, so 1 plus 0 is 1. Now, among these three, we have found four values. 1 is 1, when pi by 2 is there. Then 1.25, 1, pi by 6. Then 1, then pi. 1, then 0. That means among these three, the maximum is 1.25. That is at pi by 6. So, and 1, 1, 1. So, they are the minimum. So, here, the absolute maximum is 5 by 4. This one, that is 1.25 at x equal to pi by 6, and absolute minimum value is 1 at x equal to pi by 2, pi and 0. So that is the answer for question number 14. Thanks a lot.